Hi guys, I hope you're doing well. Welcome back to another bookish video. I know I haven't put up too many videos this month because I haven't had the time to read too many books. I only managed to read 2 books in the month of March, which has put me behind on my schedule, and I've not been able to be on track for my goal of reading 50 books this year because of the state of things and the lockdown and all of that. Somehow it's a little difficult to motivate ourselves to read as much as we would like to during uncertain times. That said, let's get down to discussing the 2 books that I read in the month of March. I read 2 phenomenal books, even though I didn't read too many. The 2 books that I read were fantastic. I read Rebecca by Daphne du Maurier, which I'll be talking about in the latter half of this video. And before that, I read The Stationery Shop of Tehran, which is written by Marjan Kamali. It's something that I've been looking forward to, and it turned out to be splendid. A very well-written book set in Tehran in the 1950s. It's about Iranian culture, and Iranian food is described so beautifully that you want to actually try making some of that at home and eat it. The center of the book is a love story, but it's done and executed so well that it does not feel like a love story. It tells you more about the other aspects, like historic facts about Iran, like the revolution that was taking place at the time, and family politics and how arranged marriage used to work back then and all of that. It's about this girl who is sent to America to study, and then she goes on to live there and have a life of her own there, but she falls in love with a man much earlier. 60 years later, she has the privilege of thinking about that story again. We find out what actually happened between her and the man, so it's a very nostalgic novel in that sense. There's a lot going on, so it has a lot of depth, and at the same time, yeah, you learn a bit about the immigration experience, going to a new land and settling, the nostalgia that you feel for your childhood. All of it explored really well by the writer. So I would definitely recommend this if you would like to escape and get lost in a certain novel. I recommend The Stationery Shop. Stationery Shop is just like a symbolic space in Tehran where the meeting between these 2 people happened in that library, which also sells stationery. And a lot of events happen around the stationery shop in Tehran. That is why the novel is called The Stationery Shop. So I highly recommend that. I also read Rebecca by Daphne du Maurier, which is such a good decision. And I can't believe that I didn't actually go and read this way earlier, because I've been missing out, and everyone who hasn't read Rebecca has been missing out. So initially you do feel like it's an overhyped book and everything, but once you pick it up and you start reading it, the first line itself is going to get you into this, and once you get sucked in, it's hard coming out because the book just gets better and better with every chapter, and the last few chapters you can't keep the book down. It's that sort of book. So I rated this 5 out of 5 stars and best reading decision of the year so far. So Rebecca is perfect for escapism, and if you like gothic fiction and if you like historic fiction, you will love Rebecca. Also, you will love Rebecca if you are somebody who can relate to the unnamed narrator, because she's an overthinker and she also spends a lot of time in her head, and she tends to get lost in her imagination. So the novel opens up in Monte Carlo, and from there we go to the British estate Manderley, which is where the rest of the novel takes place. It's not just the setting that I liked, I also liked the gothic elements, but more than that, I liked the manner in which she explores marriage and the position of a woman basically at the time, because there are 2 things happening here. Rebecca represents everything that a married woman back in the day was not expected to be. There is this mirroring that's there throughout this novel, and it's done so brilliantly, and you can read it from so many different points of view, which is why I think it's a great book club pick. In fact, I buddy read this novel, which is why it was a lot of fun, because I got to discuss it with 2 other people who also read it at the same time. Trying to reread this at some point, because I think it's just one of those novels which makes you want to think about things in a totally different way every time you approach it, and you realize so many things. Rebecca was married to Maxim, and now Rebecca is no more, and Maxim takes a new wife, and this new wife is the narrator of this novel, and she has no name, interestingly, and she's juxtaposed to Rebecca, and from the beginning she has this tendency to compare herself to Rebecca. So there's a lot of insecurity happening, and she needs to deal with her demons, and her mind is her own worst enemy. So the manner in which all of this is explored is fantastic. It's the most atmospheric novel I think that I've ever read, next to The Essex Serpent and Miniaturist perhaps. I'd recommend this to people who love atmospheric reads and would love a good escape and would just like to get lost in a narrative. I highly recommend Rebecca. So this has been my 5-star pick so far, and I hope that there'll be a few more this year, at least 2 or 3 more books. I'm looking forward to May and hope that May will be a better reading month for me, and definitely gonna try and read more 2002 books and top it up. Let me know what you're currently reading, whether you plan to pick up Rebecca anytime soon or the stationery shop. For full reviews of these, you can find it on my blog, which I'm going to link in the description box down below. So feel free to check that out. I'm also on Instagram, known as The Bookish Bulletin. So give me a follow if you like reading updates and aesthetic images every now and then. If you like this video, please feel free to subscribe and send it to somebody who you think would also like this content. I will be back soon with another bookish video. In the meantime, take care and stay safe. Bye-bye.